Good morning and welcome to the world of activity-based learning. My name is Sonia Relia and I'm an early years teacher and a teacher facilitator. I've shared my work with 60,000 teachers and each one learnt and taught me on the way. It's been a vibrant and a varied journey and I hope to keep sharing and drawing the tracks to make activity-based learning a reality with limited budgets and very, very easy activities. Connecting the three most important pillars, the teacher, the parent, and the child, for whom we are creating all these activities. When I started as an early years teacher 30 years back, there was no Google to help us. Our salaries were very, very nominal, and the resources very limited. Yet, as a pre-primary teacher, I just wanted to teach beyond the chalk and the talk. So I used to collect whatever I had in my environment and create activities for children. As the activities started working, as the children started responding, I started recording them. Over a period, I developed it into a low-cost activity-based program called Kinolearn, simply to mean kinesthetic learning, doing and learning. In the last few days, I have been getting a lot of messages from schools, from teachers, that parents are asking schools for activity lists to do at home to keep the children gainfully engaged. So I decided to use this time to record a few simple activities that you can do at home using resources that can be found in every house. These activities are also what I use for my daughter when she was small. She schooled a little later than most children do, as my husband was in the army and we were posted in the borders where she could not go to school. So I used to get a list of activities ready and I used to make little corners for her to go and do activities. And when she started schooling at about 4.5, not surprisingly, she was better equipped than most of her classmates. So today, let's begin by creating activity corners in our own home for our children. You'll be surprised how many things are readily available in your house. You just have them and you have to start your activity time. So we'll start with making a small duty chart. A simple duty chart. You don't have to have a printer. You can just draw it out for the children. You can ask them that each time they do an activity, it could be helping you to clean the house or just switching off the lights or even getting up and brushing their teeth in the morning. They could either put a little tick next to it or you can use these little stickers. So the children can actually place a little sticker and create their duty charts. Try and use as many resources, reuse them. Like I have used a back of a paper. Optimize whatever you have. I think that's a very, very important lesson for a simple activity environment. Now, cleanliness is the need of the hour. It's always been the need of the hour. So let's start with setting up a cleanliness corner. Make a little broom for your children with nice ribbons at the bottom. Have a small dustpan. Have a little duster. See that whatever material you give children is cleaned up regularly. Demonstrate how to use these and always, always wash their hands after cleaning. You will be surprised that the amount of time children will spend on a cleaning activity is amazing. They also associate it with an adult activity, so they enjoy it even more and they take their job really, really seriously. So a little cleaning corner ready for the children. Now the cleaning corner is ready. Time to make the reading corner. You can take an old card, just give it one fold, a smaller fold and two big folds and just staple it and write reading corner. Collect all the books. Ask the children to collect all their books, bring it to one place, paste them if they are torn. Check for dog ears if they are. Teach the children how to flip over pages very, very gently. Label them with numbers. Once you do that, it's easier for children to manage it. and use it again and again. Now, let's get ready to make the art corner. Again, start by asking your children to collect all the art resources that they have at home. It could be crayons, it could be paints, it could be their scissors, a scale, paints, brushes. It could be something as nice as these little clips, and collect them and put them together. They must learn this right from the early years to build a strong foundation, to grow as citizens who optimize even the natural resources that we have. It's a time of plenty. Every child has plenty of things, so we also see a lot of wastage. Perhaps it's time to help children recycle and optimize and use every resource they have. Now it's time for their toy corner, their very favorite toy corner. Put all the toys, collect them, wash them, make a little corner. If the toys are in order, if they are together, the children can actually combine them to imagine, create their own play, and just have a lot of fun. Screen time is or may not be completely avoidable in the growing digital era, but definitely it must not be a chunk of the playtime. The social, the emotional development is so important, and it only comes when the children play with each other. So that toy time is an important time. It's important for children to visualize. It's important for them to have imagination. It's important for them to role play. So spend a little time with them. Enjoy this little role play time with them. Early years are the only time when your children actually follow you around everywhere. Enjoy this time with the children. I think that's one very, very important thing to do. So for today, we are going to create our cleanliness corner, our reading corner, our art corner, and our toy corner. Once these corners are ready, you will be able to generate a lot of activities, and I'll come right back in a day or two to suggest a few more. So please enjoy the activity time with your children. Enjoy setting up space with your children, and do leave your comments, your thoughts, so that we can build more activities for you and your children. Enjoy it.